So for this problem, actually, I would like to understand three coordinate system to solving the dynamics problem, the kinematics. Okay, the kinematics problem. Actually, for any case of motion, we can apply we can solve the problem, the kinematics problem in three alternative coordinate system. First one is Cartesian XY coordinate, that's we familiar with. Okay. Second one is normal and tangential coordinate system. And the last one is the cylindrical components, or for this case, is the plane problem is reduced to a polar coordinate system. Okay. So for any case or problem, it has a particular method to solve that problem. That is give us the short solution. Okay, if we select the correct coordinate system to solve that problem, it may give us the good result with a short time. In short time, that's we may have we may not necessary to work out a lot in mathematics, or the case that we select the correct coordinate system. That is for the good example. Is in my opinion, the good example of the curvilinear motion is the circular motion. That may explain us why for to understand the coordinate system. Okay. So that's why I set up this problem. Okay. The problem is about when the particle travel in a circular path. Okay. With a constant velocity. A constant velocity means we have the total velocity is equal to 2 meters per second. Same as you drive the car, okay? When you drive a car along the curved path, and after that, your mother or your father, your parents call you and ask you about the speed or the velocity of your drive, okay? And you can observe the gate, the velocity gate, and answer your parents, okay? And this is maybe for this case, it's maybe 2 meters per second after we convert, okay, to the meter per second already. Okay, that is we normally give the answer when we drive. We have just only one answer. That's we have just only one velocity. That's we form the speed gate of our car. Okay, that is actually is the velocity in tangential direction, because we always driving car along the path. Okay, so when we drive with the constant velocity, we have Vt equal to 2 meters per second. That is given from this problem. Okay, and At, because it is constant velocity, so then it means that the acceleration along the path is become zero. It is become zero. Because when imagine that when you're increasing the speed of your car, okay, it's normally give us the increasing the speed in same direction of the path that we would like to go. Okay, when we increasing speed, that is mean that when we drive in a car and we increase the speed to our car, it mean that we give the tangential acceleration. Okay, but for the normal acceleration, is the actually from the definition, normal acceleration, it is the change in velocity direction. It's change in direction. Okay, with respect to time. Okay, we have the normal acceleration to change the direction of our motion. Okay, and for this case, the radius of a circular path is 4 meters. We would like to determine the following value, starting with the angular velocity. Okay, So for this case, we know the relationship that the velocity at any point for the circular motion, the velocity at any point along the circular path is equal to omega times r. Okay, so for this case, we already know velocity, we know r. So then we can find omega. Okay, that is the like this. Okay, we already know v and we know r. So then omega is become 0.5 radian per second. Okay, that is the direction is maybe like this. Okay, and when we working with the normal and tangential coordinate system, that is we may call this type of coordinate like the local coordinate, that is it stick on the particle and it change, also change the direction depend on the position of the particle. Also it is not fixed like xy is not changed when the particle is moved in any point. Okay, xy is still here, it's still not changed. But nt is changed, it depends on the position. For this case, at the position one, t is shown in this direction and n is perpendicular to tangential direction and always toward to the center curvature. Okay, and then if particle is moved along here, okay, so then tangent is become here. Okay, and what is the directions of normal? Should be here. Okay, you see that for the first position and second position, normal and tangential direction is different. For the first position, t is here, normal is here. This is the first one. And for the second one, normal is here and tangent is here. In the same manner, if we change position again, it should be tangent and it should be normal. Okay, this for the third position. You see that it's different with the xy coordinate that is fixed. It's always fixed. Okay, for xy, you may call it like the fixed coordinate system. Okay. So let's take a look for the case of nt coordinate. For nt coordinate, as I mentioned it's before, that we have when we driving the car along the path, the curve path, is we have just only one velocity, right? When we drive in the car, we report the speed from the speed gate of the car. We have just only one term. Okay, so then that's why we have just only one component for nt coordinate. We have velocity just only one component that is always in t direction. Okay, for nt coordinate, we have velocity vector. The velocity vector has just only one component that is in t direction. Okay, but for acceleration, we have two components. Okay, it's composed of at and an. At is for what? At is for increasing the speed. Okay, increasing the speed or decreasing. Okay, if it's decreasing, we may call deceleration instead of acceleration. Okay, so actually at it change in magnitude of velocity. Okay, but an is not related with the magnitude of velocity, but it's change in direction. An is the change in direction of velocity. Okay. When we driving a car along the curb path, okay. So when we have to have the AN, okay, because we would like, we try to change direction. We try to change direction along the curb. So we have AN according to another force that is maybe induced between the road and the wheel. Okay, this is the friction force between the wheel and the road. Okay, induced the acceleration AN. Okay, that is the change the direction, change the directions of motion. Okay, so and we know that for this case, AT is represent alpha r, right? And AN is v square over r or omega square r. Okay, AT actually equal to alpha r. Alpha is angular acceleration. AN equal to v square over r or omega square r. Okay. So for this case, AT is become zero because we are we moving, the particle is moving with the constant velocity. So then it's mean that AT is become zero. Okay, but AN is a change in direction. And we have the formula like omega square R and V square over R. And now for this case, we have V equal to 2 meters per second. And r equal to 4 meters, right? So then it means that we have an equal to 1 meter per second squared. Okay, and an is become 1 n. Okay, it has to note that an is always direct toward to the center of curvature, to the center, to this center. Okay, so you mean it means that n is always direct toward to the center of curve here. Okay, that's now we complete the second question that we would like to write the velocity vector and acceleration vector in normal and tangential coordinate system. Okay, so then we move to next coordinate. That is if we, for some case, the polar coordinate system or cylindrical coordinate system in three dimensional, we may apply the cylindrical one. Okay. It may be better for some case, but if we compare with this case, that is the circular motion, okay, we found out the velocity components for this case that we select r theta. You see, for r theta, you see that the coordinate r is measured from the center point, okay, go upward from the center point. Okay, so then r is, if we compare with normal and tangential, you will see that r is the opposite direction with n. Okay, and what is the direction of theta? Theta is always perpendicular to r. So then if r is goes in which direction, theta is perpendicular to the direction of r. And the positive arrow is depend on the directions of rotation. So for this case, we rotate counterclockwise. So then theta is should be in this direction. Okay. So in the same manner as the normal and tangential coordinate system, r theta is the local coordinate also. It is not fixed. Okay, it change when it change the position, when the particle change the position. So then it is for the first position, we have r here and we have theta here. Okay, so then if the particle is moving to this position again, to this position, to the second position instead, so then we have Okay, and we have tera here. Okay, if it's moved to this, okay, we have and we also have tera. Okay, you see that it is not the fixed coordinate like xy. Xy is always fixed for any time and any position. And when we solve with the polar coordinate system, we will use the formula that we know that the velocity is composed of two components. The first one is R component, that is the velocity along the R axis. Okay, that is equal to R dot. Okay, and we have another component, that is the velocity along the theta component, that is R theta dot. Okay. So for this case, we know that because it is a circular path, so then R is become constant. For this case, we have R dot is become zero, and theta dot is equal to omega. So according to this, we found out the velocity vector in term of R and theta, we have just only one term, that is equal to 2 u theta. Okay. And if you compare with the normal and tangential, you will see that actually we get the same magnitude of velocity, that is equal to 2 meters per second, right? Okay. But for R theta, it's represented in theta direction. That's for this case, for the particular case of the circular motion, theta and t is in the same direction. Just for only this case, that is the circular motion. Theta and t are collide to each other. Okay. And when we working with the acceleration, we know that the acceleration for our theta component is composed of two components, that is the AR and A theta. AR equal to R double dot minus R theta dot square. Okay. And A theta equal to R theta dot dot. Okay. Second dot, this is mean that theta dot dot is equal to D2 theta by D2. Okay. That's actually is equal to alpha. Okay. And plus 2R dot theta dot. Okay. But we know that we know from the previous one that for this case, it did a circular motion, it's become constant, so then R double dot is become zero. Okay. And theta double dot, because omega, for this case, omega is constant according to the velocity is constant. So then theta double dot is become zero. Okay, and for the second term, R dot is become zero. So then that's why A theta becomes zero now. Okay, we have actually one component. Okay, we substitute the value that we already know, R equal to 4 meter, R dot equal to zero, R double dot equal to zero, theta dot is equal to omega, as we already know that it is equal to 0.5 radian per second. And for theta double dot, for this case, it becomes zero. So then that's why we got the acceleration vector in term of and theta here. That's you will see that we have the negative sign. Okay, here. Why? Because the acceleration that we get actually is the normal acceleration, right? The normal acceleration in positive one, this is the direction of this acceleration is toward to the center of curve. But for the coordinate system of R theta, the positive R is go outward from the center of curve. Okay, so then that's why acceleration in term of R theta is become negative like this. Okay, because it's opposite to the positive R. Okay. So for the last one, that is the velocity and acceleration in terms of rectangular components. Okay. For the rectangular components, we know that x, y is fixed. Okay. If we solve this circular motion in terms of x, y coordinate, we have to change the coordinate system to be x, y. That is actually for circular motion, we represent the motion in terms of r theta or nt is maybe easier, okay? But if we would like to determine it in terms of x and y, that's okay, okay? For this case, we know that for r and theta, we can relate r and theta in terms of x and y like this. So for the Cartesian coordinate, the position vector at any point, okay, we represent with x and y coordinate that are fixed, okay? That's our fixed. And the coordinate x, y is related by the r theta component. We know that x is equal to r cosine theta and y equal to r sine theta, okay? And after that, we get this vector. We would like to find the velocity. We just take the first derivative to the position vector here. And according to the chain rule, we obtain this term. This is the velocity vector. And if we would like to determine the magnitude of velocity, okay, we use the property of the trigonometry function, okay? We obtain here, that is the magnitude of velocity is become 2 meters per second. That is equivalent with the velocity in tangential direction. That is actually for the velocity in tangential direction, we can decompose it into X component and Y component like this, okay? So then we have the velocity vector here and the magnitude is same as the tangential direction. Okay, so for next, okay, this is just for the explanation that for the position that we observe, you will see that the velocity is in this direction, in green direction, right? And when we decompose into x and y, should be in negative x and in positive y, okay? In the same manner, for the acceleration, we take the first derivative to velocity, and it is the second derivative of the position vector. Okay, we apply the chain rule, and for the mathematical, we take the derivative of this term. That is, we will see that we have the term of sine theta and theta dot. Okay, so it should have these two components. Okay. And on for the J components also, okay. But after we substitute each value that is omega dot, theta double dot, okay, that is equal to 0 for this case, into this vector, we can determine that for the case of I equal to 4 meter, and omega equal to 0.5, we got the acceleration vector is become minus cosine theta I minus sine theta j, okay? And when we find the magnitude of velocity and acceleration, we got that velocity, the magnitude of velocity is become 2 meters per second. That is equal to the velocity in tangential direction, which is always in tangent direction, okay? And for the acceleration, we obtain the acceleration to become 1. That is for this case, A has only one component in normal direction. And actually if Vt is not constant, At will not equal to 0. And the magnitude of V and A for all coordinate system, you will see that is the equivalent. Okay, that is the why I set up this problem to you in a because I think this is, in my opinion, I think this is a good example to understand all coordinate system that is x, y coordinate. NT coordinate and R theta coordinate. This maybe help us a lot if we are familiar with this for the case that like this example, that is maybe the basic one. So that's complete this problem. So do you have